Learning your ABCs with all your buddies.
I'm Miss Jillian.
And I'm Pastor G. Jesus loves you, and so do we.
Oh, snap! Welcome to another Bible ABCs. Oh, can you start us off, Miss Jillian?
Sure. Today's letter is S. This is an uppercase S, and this is a lowercase S. S makes the S sound like in sunglasses.
Yay!
Or socks.
Sweet, salty socks.
You know another word that starts with S? Sore. I am really sore. My muscles are sore because I've been working out with my sons, and they did not take it easy on me.
Why were you working out?
I'm expecting to do some heavy lifting for our rummage sale coming up. And maybe, if I get strong enough, I can lift a couch all by myself.
That doesn't sound so smart. If you have to lift something heavy, you should seek help.
Yeah!
Samuel, our Bible character for today, also sought help.
Samuel lived in the temple of God, and a man named Eli took care of Samuel. And in turn, Samuel helped Eli take care of the temple. One night, when he was sleeping soundly, he heard a sound, and he thought someone was calling his name while he slept.
Was it Eli who was calling Samuel?
No, it was God. God had a message for Samuel. In fact, this was just the first message God gave Samuel. Samuel would have several messages to speak to God's people.
What kinds of messages were they?
Well, first of all, they were important messages. Sometimes they were warnings about doing what God said. Other times they were telling people about how God was going to lead his people or save his people from trouble.
It sounds like Samuel did something very important just by telling people God's messages.
Yes, it was spectacular. Samuel didn't really perform many miracles or do anything that impressive. However, in sharing God's messages, warnings, and promises, he was doing one of the most important things of all, encouraging us to listen to our God who saves us.
It's super smart to listen to God and the messages he sends us.
Sure is. And as we get closer and closer to Easter, it's especially good to listen to God's best messenger, Jesus, our Savior. He can tell us what to do, but he also promises to love and forgive us, even when we make mistakes.
Well, that's all for now. We'll see you next time at the next Bible ABCs.
And remember, if you're lifting something really, really heavy, make sure it's a team effort.
I'm Miss Jillian.
And I'm Pastor G. Jesus loves you, and so do we.